Welcome back. Another one of Alexi's amigos, Durgadas Kamat, Goa's best-known Himalayan trekker, presented a talk and slideshow on his trekking experience.
He started by explaining that there are various technical terms that are used to describe climbing mountains and hills. Yet what really matters is the systematic way of the climbing experience.
A layman's language I should know about the mountaineering is the systematic way of climbing the mountains with the help of all these gears like ropes, the ladders, like the oxygen cylinders and all these things.
He explained trekking in very simple terms and compared it to walking.
Trekking is possible, not necessary in mountain, it is possible even on the roads. What is the meaning of trekking? It's just walking, looking around here and there, enjoying the nature, that's all.
He said that people are scared of trekking because of the kind of an impression created in movies. All that a layman has to do is undergo basic training for trekking.
We decide where we have our impression upon seeing something in the movies or in the pictures. And we see people climbing like this. Yes, there are those mountaineers, the professional mountaineers needs all those gears and equipments. But for a common man, to enjoy the trekking, to enjoy the beautiful scenery of the mountains, you don't require all these things. What you require is the great zeal, a basic requirement like your good shoes, your warm clothing, etc., etc.
Durgadas Kamat recollected his first trekking experience 30 years ago.
30 years back, 1977, the first opportunity came to me for the basic mountaineering course at Manali. You will not believe the fee was 180 rupees for 30 days. But being the only son of my parent, my mother said, my son, I don't mind giving 180, you take 200 rupees. But no, not going.
He said that today people do not come forward out of ignorance. But he assured that once you experience it, you'll always look forward to the experience.
Every parent thinks in this direction that yes, trekking is so dangerous and all these things. So that is how the one biggest hurdle we are facing because of the ignorance. We don't know the systematic way of mountaineering and trekking. But last about 10-15 years, what I see, it is picking up slowly and slowly in Goa, although it is far. And compared to other states like Maharashtra or Gujarat, especially Gujarat, it is picking up now in Goa also. Believe me, I am sure Alexis will agree, Tekla will agree. Once you have that view of Himalaya, you are hooked to it. The addiction started there and there. That's how it took me to so many places. I will not remember also all those places.
He spoke about Khumbu Valley below Mount Everest.
Khumbu Valley, which is the highest place below Mount Everest. The Khumbu Valley is treated as the highest graveyard in the world. You don't know, thousands of bodies are lying there. Some are dead 40, 50, 60, 70 years back. Bodies intact. The reason, temperature there remains minus 20 even in summer. But still, people are going because people want something new, something adventurous, some adventurous and all this thing. Normally, previously I used to be leading in front. Now I always prefer to be last so that I can enjoy more.
Talking about his experience, he said that these are places where he thought he would find God.
But and I was always having a talk with the guide. So one guide, when he was climbing and almost the snow line came, he just bent and touched and prayed. I said, what you are doing? He says, no, this is the snow. And as they say, Himalaya is the place of Lord Shiva. He says, this is flowing from the jatas. I don't know what you call about it, jatas. Those hairs, no? It is flowing from his hair. So it is as pure. It is pure. Naturally it is pure. As pure as God's gift. So Before touching my feet, I should pray.
The talk was followed by music by Caetano Aprio.
Eu já perdoei. Se ela voltasse, feliz eu serei. Saudade, saudade sem fim, de um grande amor, que esqueceu de mim. Se ela voltasse ao meu braço outra vez, eu esqueceria o que ela me fez.
That's all we have for you today. Before we end, here is a reminder of our headlines. Goa Pradesh Youth Congress demands judicial inquiry into attack on them by Babush's supporters in December. Jennifer Montserrat lodges her complaint with Goa State Women's Commission. Dr. Wilfred D'Souza does not rule out polls in Goa. Sanjay Dutt and Manyata unties knot. We'll be back tomorrow with more news and analysis for you. Until then, it's goodbye and good night.